It's an international internet blackout. As you may have noticed, some of your favorite websites are blocking access to their sites tonight to protest anti-piracy bills in Congress. Eyewitness News reporter Susan Hogan's been following the blackout and the impact it could have on you. She joins us now live with new details.
Well, all day today, the House Judiciary Committee has been debating its very controversial bill. The Senate has already passed a similar bill. But today's blackout by some of the major internet companies definitely created a lot of interest and may have just gotten the attention they wanted.
For people like Sarah Reese, Wikipedia is indispensable.
Composers, people, actors, countries, whatever you need to know, you can go to Wikipedia.
But for a 24-hour period, Wikipedia, along with other websites like Reddit and Boing Boing, have closed its virtual doors in protest to two pieces of legislation. The U.S. House of Representatives bill called Stop Online Piracy Act, or SOPA, and the Senate version called Protect IP Act, or PIPA, has huge support from copyright holders, including the music and film industries, who say the new legislation is essential for battling rampant internet piracy.
What these bills will do is require U.S. internet service providers to pretend that these allegedly pirate websites don't exist, sort of virtually disappear from the internet.
But some internet companies like Wikipedia and Google are outraged, saying the bills will essentially break the internet. Speaking from his Washington, D.C. offices, Congressman Jim Langevin has expressed his opposition to the bill.
I think it's the wrong approach. It's using a sledgehammer when, you know, something smaller could be used to address the problem.
Both Congressman David Cicilline and Senator Jack Reed have also spoken out against the SOPA Act as it's currently drafted. Senator Jack Reed says, "I'm very worried that these bills could have unknown and damaging impacts on other important policy goals." Only Congressman Sheldon Whitehouse has voiced his support, saying foreign websites dedicated to selling fraudulent products are part of a cybercrime industry that threatens these jobs and can result in American consumers being seriously injured.
But there is no doubt the blackout today has brought attention to both bills and is likely to slow lawmakers down from making any decision on either. I'm Susan Hogan, Eyewitness News.